What's common between the master cataloger and this girl? Well, indirectly, both were influenced by Leonhard Euler, a Swiss mathematician who lived 300 years ago. In the case of MasterCard, we're talking about Euler diagrams that conveniently illustrate various life wisdom. But when it comes to an AI-generated image, things get much more interesting. When trying to create your first AI masterpiece in the list of various parameters, you definitely noticed a sampler with a variety of options including Euler. But what is it exactly? What are samplers for and how does it differ? Why do they have such strange names and is it all mathematicians too? In reality, no, there are also some musicians. Today we will talk about it and we will find out how they work, how to choose the best sampler for you and saving a lot of time and effort, and why there are more and more of them with each automatic 11.11 update. For a beginning, we need to understand how diffusion models work, and stable diffusion in particular. Imagine you have a skilled art restoration expert who is really good at identifying and removing stains from old paintings. He was trained by looking at many paintings with different types of stains and learning how to clean them. Now, let's say you have an old painting with some stains on it. You ask the expert to clean the painting. If the stains are indeed dirt and damage, the expert will remove them, revealing the true beauty of the original artwork. This is similar to the denoising process, where you remove the unwanted noise from a noisy image to reveal the underlying content. But what if you start with a black canvas, covered in random stains? Even in this case, the expert can guide you on how to clean it, telling you which stains to remove. After you follow his instructions and clean the canvas, what you have left is a piece of art that the expert imagined based on his knowledge of art and restoration techniques. In this analogy, the art restoration expert represents the neural network model, and the cleaning process mirrors the denoising process. Whether you start with a stained painting or a black canvas of stains, the expert can help you reveal the true beauty or hallucinate a meaningful image based on their learned expertise. And here a very important and fascinating conclusion. The model doesn't generate the image. It's already here, right in this noise. The model only knows how to correctly remove the unnecessary parts, or in other words, noise. Do you remember Michelangelo? When he was asked how he creates David sculptures, he said, "You just chip away everything that doesn't look like a David." The point is, everything is already there in that stone. It contains all possible sculptures. The artist's role is to choose what is unnecessary. That's exactly how the model works. It knows what's unnecessary, but doesn't create anything directly. Its expertise, or in other words, its training, and how well it understands your request, or in other words, prompt, defines the quality of the final result. The denoising process, or in other words, the removal of stains according to our analogy, is referring to a sampling, because stable diffusion generates a new sample image at each step. The method used in sampling is called the sampler or sampling method. All the samplers are essentially different algorithms for numerically approximating solution to differential equations. I know that sounds a bit complicated, but it's not so difficult as it seems so. The primary goal of these algorithms is to find an image that is close to perfect, with minimal error and an optimal time. The solution of differential equation is essentially the search for the deepest point in the ocean, but the problem is that there are so many of these points that we can only find one of the deepest ones by approximating the deepest. The method we use to solve these equations are samplers. The only difference is that this ocean is multidimensional, because differential equations have much more than three variables. Now you are familiar with the theory, let's figure out which samplers is the best to choose. There are many of them, and each has its pros and cons. Some of them are outdated, while others, like the mentioned Euler, seems to always be relevant. Euler, the simplest solving technique, introduced by Leonhard Euler nearly 300 years ago. While it's straightforward and computationally efficient and doesn't offer the highest level of accuracy, If you see a sampler with single letter A, it means ancestral sampler. An ancestral sampler adds noise to the image at each sampling step. They are stochastic samplers, because the sampling outcome has some randomness to it. The main drawback of using an ancestral sampler is that the image would not converge. In other words, there might be too much variation from step to step, and this is very bad for reproduction. If you need to create various variations of an image, for instance to generate a character or an AI influencer, do not use sampler with the letter A. Behind each sampler, there is quite complex mathematics that you can even understand yourself, if you look at the code of these samplers. But I don't see the point in analyzing each sampler individually, as there are too much of them. Let's instead focus on samplers from the perspective of several key parameters that are important to us as users: speed, quality, and convergence. The best way to compare them is, of course, to look at the benchmark. Fortunately, I stumbled upon the website stablediffusionarc.com, where all of this had already been done before me, for which I am immensely grateful. The charts may seem a bit daunting, but believe me, they are not so difficult to understand. And of course, I will explain everything. And also important to note, they are much more convenient than looking at direct comparison of images, because the attractiveness of the images can vary greatly depending on the model, style, or even the prompt. Let's start with the most noticeable and, for most of us, important aspect: speed or rendering time. The graph depicts the rendering time for each of the samplers in relative units. Obviously, the smaller the column, the faster the image generation. In this case, the simplest sampler is Euler, and unsurprisingly, it's also the fastest sampler. Euler A and UniPC are in a second place and quite close to the basic Euler. Other samplers are noticeably slower, but that metric doesn't mean much without another parameter, quality. So let's look how quickly each sampler can produce a high-quality image. You will see perceptual quality measure with BISQI, Blind Referenceless Image Spatial Quality Evaluator. It measures the quality of natural images. I'll tell you right away, there is no need to be afraid of these charts. I'll explain everything, and they are actually quite simple. Moreover, they are incredibly useful, because with their help you can determine the optimal number of steps you need to choose when generating images, which is very nice. The chart consists of two axes. The first one, horizontal, represents sampling steps, which is the parameter you choose when generating images. The second one, the vertical axis, represents quality. Here, things are a bit counterintuitive. The lower the quality, the better. That's all you need to know to understand these graphs. According to the graph, we can see that DDIM is the best sampler, because it has the highest quality among all. At the same time, we can observe that it reached fairly high quality at around 8 steps. In other words, increasing the number of steps for further quality improvement doesn't make much sense. Therefore, DDIM sampling steps 8 is the best value. In this case, Euler provides the best quality at 10 steps, being that the quality increases, but it's not worth improving it further, because the generation time would become too long. As we can see, PLMS performs worse than all. It only achieves quality at significantly high steps, 30 and above. By the way, it's considered outdated, and very few people use it nowadays. In the next graph, with ancestral samplers, we can see that Euler A sampler performs the best, providing the highest quality at 16 sampling steps. Considering that it's nearly as fast as a regular Euler, this is a very good choice. At the same time, we can observe DPM2A Keras looks significantly worse, and I don't see much point in using it, unless at very high sampling steps. But overall, all the ancestral samplers shown here appear quite similar. DPM samplers look somewhat worse and slightly outperform Euler. DPM Adaptive stands out as it maintains relatively consistent quality regardless of the number of steps. On the next graph, we are comparing Euler with DPM++ samplers. It's easy to notice that the two DPM++ samplers, DPM++ SDE and SDE Keras, perform the best. In the case of DPM SDE, it achieves the best result at 10 steps. At the same time, The same can be said for Keras, which provides optimal quality at around 10 steps and very best at 18 steps. The next parameter we need to assess is convergence, which we already discussed when talking about the ancestral sample. Just to remind you, this parameter assesses the variability of images at each step, which is crucial for generating variation of single image. I don't believe it's necessary to evaluate every plot in this case. I will just explain how to interpret these plots. This graph looks quite similar to the previous one, with the only difference being that instead of parameter responsible for quality, we have parameter for convergence level. The lower this parameter, the better. On the horizontal axis, it's still the number of steps. You can evaluate these graphs yourself and choose the best sampler for you based on this parameter. I'll just note that samplers with A ancestral sampler tend to stand out significantly, which is not surprising given the high variability. Just look at this significant difference compared to the regular Euler. At the same time, the convergence of DPM adaptive is surprisingly low and doesn't depend on the number of steps. So for those who enjoy creating identical character or AI influencer, take a closer look at this sampler. Now, how to choose the best sampler? So it's quite simple. When it comes to evaluating the quality of generations, you will undoubtedly face the issue that the perception of the quality is still very subjective. To form your own opinion about what you like the most, I suggest going into the Automatic 1111 and using the grid prompt tool to generate grid of different images with your model, your prompt, and your style. So just see what you like the most. Select trio of favorites with different prompts, then open the speed chart and choose the best one for you, based on perception and generation speed. If the convergence of image is also important to you, open the convergence chart and make decision based on speed and convergence. If you don't want to get involved in all these chart benchmarks and for some reason watch this video until this point, I'll say the following. If speed is the only thing that matters to you, then the best option for you is Euler, Heon, and if you are not concerned about convergence, then Euler A. As for selecting the optimal step size, I have mentioned that before, but they shouldn't be so high. If you want good quality images and don't care about convergence, good choice are DPM++ SDE Keras, with about 10-15 steps, DDIM with 10-15 steps also. But note that the first one also not so fast. If convergence is important to you, then DPM adaptive is your choice, but please note that it's very slow. And of course, avoid using any ancestral samplers if you prefer stable, reproducible images. In addition, when choosing models, there are recommendations from the authors itself regarding which samplers to select, and you can find this information in the model descriptions. You can also add custom samplers by downloading them directly from CVTI. However, I must emphasize that this is quite subjective. Such recommendations may be based on the fact that certain samplers, due to their precision or error, create different vibes that may look better or worse depending on the style being used. When I see Euler sampler, I sometimes think about how amazing it is that this mathematical method, developed over 300 years ago, still profoundly impact on cutting-edge technologies and also helping some to create unique innovative products and enabling others to bring their dreams, ideas, and fantasies to life.